Hello, welcome. I'm Dr. Christine Bradstreet, bringing you another video about success on the spectrum. Do people with autism experience more pain? Very good question. And this scientific study landed in my inbox, and I thought I would research it and share the information with you. So again, welcome. I'm Dr. Christine Bradstreet. I'm a retired chiropractor, and I run this site here where I share my knowledge about health and wellness and having success on the spectrum. Now, before I go any further, while you're here, please subscribe to the channel and hit the bell so you'll get notified when I go live. When you subscribe to a YouTube channel, it's like supporting a local small business, but it doesn't cost you any money. So thank you very much for subscribing. So possibly you've asked this question yourself if you have chronic pain. Do people on the autism spectrum experience more pain? The answer is yes, they do. And I'm going to tell you briefly why without going into too much of a science deep dive. Let me explain what's going on. So people on the autism spectrum tend to experience more pain and also have a lesser ability to inhibit pain. So that's a bit of a double whammy there. Unfortunately, it's a very harmful myth or belief that people with autism are insensitive to pain, because it's common to see self-harm like head banging or hitting in people more severely afflicted with autism. So people develop the inaccurate belief that these people didn't feel pain. It's the opposite. The theory now is that people self-harm in a way to suppress the pain that they're feeling. So very dangerous belief that people with autism are insensitive to pain, because it's actually the opposite. So I will post a link to the study in the comments and in the description to the video. But what they found was a heightened awareness of pain in people on the autism spectrum, as well as an inability to filter out pain or stimulation in people on the autism spectrum. And when you put those things together, it does lead to heightened feeling of pain in people with autism. Also, people with autism may express that they're feeling pain in ways that are not typical. So the people around them, parents, teachers, peers, aren't understanding that the person is in pain, because the person isn't verbalizing it in a way that makes the other person understand what's going on. And that's something that, depending on communication abilities, some of us can work on that to be better communicators about our pain, but that might not be possible for everybody. So the more caregivers can become aware of this, what are the signs, what are the signals that my loved one is giving when they're in pain, then they'll be able to be of better help to the person that they love. So there's something called sensory modulation dysfunction, and this is present in about 10% of the population anyway, but it's present in about 70 to 90% of people on the autism spectrum. And what this means, it means there's a very heightened awareness and an inability to ignore some sensory inputs. And I'm going to read a quote out of the article for you, because this really intrigued me. So, referring to people with sensory modulation dysfunction, these people have difficulty, for example, ignoring or adapting to buzzing or flickering of fluorescent lights, humming of air conditioners or fans, or the crunching of popcorn by someone sitting next to you in the movie theater. In previous studies in the lab, we found that these people suffer from pain more than those without sensory modulation dysfunction. So sensory modulation dysfunction is linked with higher awareness or a higher experience of pain. So to summarize it, people on the autism spectrum have a heightened awareness of the pain and a lessened ability to either ignore it, be distracted from it, or adapt to it. Double whammy. So do not despair, my friends. On this channel, I have lots of resources for things that you can do to help dampen this hypersensitivity. And you can find yoga, breath work, and meditation videos all scientifically proven to help stimulate the parasympathetic part of your nervous system, which is the part of your nervous system that calms all these things down. So you're in the right place, my friends, to have more success on the spectrum, to be happier, healthier, healthier in your mind, in your body, in your spirit. Thanks so much for being here. We'll talk soon.